start, unlike natural calamities that are beyond human control, avoidable disasters resulting from human error or negligence prove more tragic and completely imbalance the intergenerational equity and cause irretrievable damage to the health and environment for generations to come. Such tragedy may occur from pure negligence, contributory negligence, or even failure to take necessary precautions in carrying on certain industrial activities. More often than not, the affected parties have to face avoidable damage and adversity that results from such disasters. The magnitude and extent of adverse impact on the financial soundness, social health, and upbringing of younger generation may have been beyond human expectations. In such situations, and where the laws are silent or are inadequate, the courts have unexceptionally stepped in to bridge the gaps, to provide for appropriate directions and guidelines to ensure that fundamentals of Article 21 of the Constitution of India are not violated. The Bhopal gas tragedy is a glaring example of such imbalances and adverse impacts whereby courts intervention, poor and destitute have been provided relief and rehabilitation. The Bhopal gas leak disaster occurred on the intervening night of the 2nd December 1984. Data reflecting the exact number of affected persons was not available initially. Earlier, it was felt that only a small number of persons were adversely affected in terms of health or otherwise by the leakage of toxic gases from the Union Carbide unit at Bhopal. However, the Scientific Commission released a report titled The Bhopal Gas Disaster Effects on Life Systems in July 1987, which suggested otherwise. This report stated that for the estimated population of 2 lakh exposed to the toxic gases in the severely and moderately affected areas of Bhopal and the variety of long-term problems anticipated in the crisis period, the number of exposures covered so far by the Indian Council for Medical Research through the medical surveys constitute less than 20% of the population. With the passage of time, this figure of the affected population has fallen to nearly 5 lakh. By the same scientific commission, it was also found that in general, the output of the medical project so far had not equaled the magnitude of the tasks assigned to them, presumably due to lack of resources, trained staff, as well as physical inputs. This has to be remedied in the shortest time so that project is completed fully. It is urged by him that the High Court has fallen into error by opining that there was no justification to exercise jurisdiction under Article 226 of the Constitution of India whereas the facts stated warranted deletion of such an observation by the DRAT, as a tribunal has no jurisdiction to grant such liberty, and especially when a settlement between the borrower and auction purchaser had been arrived at. Learned counsel would submit that the DRAT had really not addressed to any issue, and after recording a settlement in a most brief manner. Stop.